Hello everybody and welcome back to Let's Play Xanadu for the MSX. So in this part we will be taking on the level 9 towers as we discussed earlier. And we'll be going for this small one first. Now actually looks are a bit deceiving here because the insides aren't actually as small as this tower would appear. Let's see, what do we want? I think I'll take another demon's ring. Let me check real quick how many we have left. 15 demon's rings, 20 hourglasses. You know what? Maybe we'll use an hourglass instead. There we go. And immediately you'll see why this is a good idea. We'll pick up a plus 5 shield right away, and a luck blade as well, which actually we will not be using for the moment, because we'll find an even better item deeper in the tower. Let's see, let's get down here. And in fact, I'm going to save most of these monsters for on the way back, just so we can get a little bit more experience with our new weapon once we pick it up. So for the time being, I'm just going to kill the ones that are in our way, and thanks to the hourglass, that's going to be very easy. I'm even going to skip this glove for the moment. Let's see, where do we go from here? This way, I think. And this is another trick you can do with these towers. If you use an hourglass, you can actually leave all the monsters alive, which means that your hourglass will last indefinitely, as long as you don't run into any empty rooms. Wait, what do we do here? Yep, north. And then north again. I think. Yeah, that's right. And as you saw there, we picked up our Murasame blade, which is the one we really want. I think this is poison, isn't it?
Yeah.
We'll avoid this one. I'll just get rid of it. So from now on we will be fighting these guys. I think after this tower we'll have a look and see if we have enough enough money to upgrade our magic spell as well. Hopefully we'll be upgrading to the final spell in the game, which is the death spell. We do want to push on a little bit through this tower still, because if I am not mistaken, yeah, we have some stat ups and some other stuff we still want to pick up here. Let me see. Yep. Down here, and then I think we'll go to the left first. Yeah, we'll go left first. So yeah, again, if you leave one of these guys alive, I should have probably left one of them alive next to the door right here, you won't waste any time getting through these rooms, and you'll be able to clear out almost the entire tower with a single hourglass or demon ring. You can wait. Now we will pick up the gloves because we want the experience with our better weapon. And food, well, that's going to be almost worthless. We'll waste more food walking to the food items than we get from picking them up, so we're just going to ignore those. Pick up some spare bottles, which will come in handy when we start to upgrade our magic spell in a minute. And then hopefully our hourglass hasn't run out yet.
Yep.
Then your luck will be able to clear out the entire tower with one or maybe two hourglasses. Below so we can get outside immediately. Wait, is this poison? Yes it is. So that means we are going to ignore it, and actually I'm going to skip this one for the moment. Oh, here's another stat up, plus 10 dexterity as well as plus 10 intelligence. Some more magic experience. You know what, let's give it to our dex spell. And through here. Winged boot, which is also very nice, of course. And then, well, the benefit of going through here is a little bit debatable, because the reward at the end of this tunnel, which cost us a couple of keys, is going to be 9 red potions. Now, I don't know if that's really worth it, but I'm just going to pick them up anyway. And these spectacles, well, we don't really use them, but might as well get a few more. And now that we have our upgraded sword, oops, looks like our hourglass ran out. Now that we do have our upgraded sword, I think we should be able to damage these. Not quite yet. Yeah, our strength is just a little too low still. So these level 4 Galardur guys are still going to be beyond our ability for the moment. But I think if we pick up enough experience with our Masamune, or what's it called? Murasame Blade, we will be able to kill them eventually. So that's pretty much tower number one, I believe. Was there anything else I needed in here? We'll see in a moment. These guys should give us another bottle. There we go. Get the poison out of the way. Let's see, yep, and then to the left. Back into the main tower. I think these guys are poisonous too, aren't they? Oh no, they're food, okay. Well, we want the experience. So we might as well kill them. No, we didn't pick up any armor. Okay, so further down this way, and then down again. Yep. Not sure, I think we've cleared out this tower by now. Except for, of course, the monsters we left on the way in. These guys, for example. These are also poisonous, so I'm just gonna leave this last one. Oh well, might as well pick up the experience, but... And then these guys drop a key, which will be useful to us, so we'll take them out. Clearly we've already wasted a bunch of keys getting down here, so it doesn't hurt to pick up a few new ones. And yeah, I'm just gonna leave that one, whatever. These guys on the other hand have a good drop, so we will kill them. Well, good, I mean. Honestly, at this point, most of the items we're not going to be using anymore. I think from here on it's going to be mostly Demon's Rings and the Hourglass. And of course lamps and that sort of thing. But things like Fire Crystals, I don't think we'll be going back to the King anymore. So it doesn't really matter at this point. But as you can see, we cleared the entire tower with just 2 Hourglasses. And we picked up a ton of fighter experience once again. At no risk at all to ourselves. I think that's it for the tower. Oh yeah, these guys. Looks like we don't have quite enough gold for the death spell yet, although actually maybe we do if we sell some of our other loots. we go. One more of these guys and we are home free. I think we can sell our tilt spell and a couple of our other items that we picked up, and that might actually be enough to get us to our... let's go here to the shops. I think if we sell all our stuff, then we will be close enough. Yeah, we don't want this anymore. Don't want this anymore. We don't need an inn, we don't need a temple quite yet. Do we need a... Actually, you know what? We're at a million experience points with our fighter. Let's see if that's enough to level up. Paladin. So one more level for us. We have enough keys, we have enough food for the moment. Yeah, let's see if we have any shields to sell. Oh no, we want to equip our +5 large shield, of course. And sell our old +4. I think we have some armors as well. Oh. No, we don't. Equip magic. Corrosion, and we will sell our tilt spell as well, and that will easily give us enough to buy the final spell in the game. So without further ado, let's equip our bottle, use it, and buy the final spell, which is death. Sorry. And this will give us our cool unique item, unique icon. The other ones are all indicated by letters, but the death spell is the only one which has a skull and crossbones, which is quite nice. So that's pretty much it for the small tower for this level. We will also be clearing out the large one, or the medium one I should say. The large one we'll save for later because it's got the end boss for this level, and the end boss is at the moment a little bit too strong for us still. Actually, these guys are too for now. The reason I want to clear out this tower is because it upgrades our armor. So, we will be taking on that on next, but we'll do that in the next part because we're running out of time again. Yeah. I will end it here. Thanks for watching, guys, and I'll see you in the next one.